But we've got a potential Olympian, Lance, that has like a 52-second 400-meter run. Lindsey Smith with a heptathlete. Nicole Christensen's from Boulder, so she's probably got like a whole host of like spirit animals in her corner, stuff like that, you know, gonna make her faster. And Todd Whitman's just one of the strongest dudes I know, so I'm gonna crush him. I'm gonna crush all of them.
You know, like, just recently getting back into the sprinting scene, I'm nervous. I can't lie. Lindsey, Spencer, a lot of speed demons here, so.
Oh, really?
It'll be good. Oh. And Eric, look at this guy.
Are the Maasai warriors of Kenya worried about running mechanics? I don't know. That's all I have to say.
That's true.
I think he's feeling spicy. Look at this.
That's true. See that? Yeah. Miko right now is throwing up. He's like, no, not in my shirt. not those times.
That particularly is such a different hard workout than sitting like Helen, Fran, Linda, you could do. Equally, if not more, because it's that much different, maybe unfamiliar with a lot of people as familiar we are with, you know, CrossFit metabolic conditioning workouts. It's just totally different, like tapping into a fast twitch muscle, like, yeah, high power output, digging in, it's not easy at all. I think so much benefit that maybe, I would say definitely majority of people don't spend enough time doing, probably definitely not myself included.
Rock down inclusive does not include cheating.
Overheating.
You could put your Khalifa one on.
Exactly.
You know, you never hear somebody pulling a glute. You only hear about somebody pulling a hamstring or a quad, and it's usually because they strike out in front instead of right underneath their hip. So just like, you know, you see the marathon runner with a heel strike and their hips are back. The same thing applies when you're fatigued and you sprint. So it's super important to have the pelvis rolled forward instead of back. So if you roll forward, 9 times out of 10, when you strike, you'll be underneath your hip. And anytime somebody pulls a hamstring, it's usually because they reach out in front when they strike.
Maasai warrior.
Wounded buffalo. Wounded buffalo.
Great. There's two left. You know, you're taking away my 14. Recovery by having me talk between rounds. Yeah. Who paid you?
It's like you see, you know, 10, 100 meter sprints, like, well, what's the WOD after that? Or I just did Helen after that or something. Same thing with 7 sets of 1 on deadlift. Like, is that it? Question, hey, don't do it right at all. Definitely not using max effort. Like right now, I'm wasting. I was planning on doing another WOD after the seminar today just because it would be a good variance piece in my training right now, but right now I'm doubting myself that I could even like do anything at a reasonable effort to get any kind of adaptation, you know?
And you know what, I'll say this to the whole CrossFit community, and it might not come off very popular. It's like, who am I? Just a guy from Dallas. But if you're doing that workout and say the rest periods are right, you should be on the ground after that workout. Yeah. I know that it's popular in our community to, you know, not show your weakness and to stand up like a, whatever Miko said, like an animal. Yeah, you know, yeah. If an animal's laying down, it means it's weak.
Something.
That's only true for certain workouts. I think there's some workouts where, like, if you're not on the ground, like, you didn't dose it correctly enough.